It's official. After several deaths and suicide attempts, the government enacted legislation banning yoga. Practitioners of yoga are ordered to cease any yoga-related activities immediately, turn in any yoga materials or equipment to neighborhood safety patrols by midnight tonight, and report to their nearest police station to enroll in re-education courses.
Are you Diane Adams?
Yes.
Miss Adams, my name is Officer Williams. Are you currently enrolled in yoga classes at the Sunnyside Recreation Center? Is that a yoga mat?
It's for Pilates.
And Miss Adams, are those yoga pants?
Pilates pants?
And what is that? Bring her in.
As police conduct arrests tonight, the government wants to remind citizens that this is for your own protection. If you have a family member or acquaintance involved with anything yoga related, don't hesitate to report them. Police have already arrested over 5,000 who have refused to give up their practice and have confiscated yoga mats, instructional videos, scented candles, and incense.
Do you agree to give up your practice?
Apprehending cult members is tiring work, but many are working overtime to get the job done. This is how much the government cares about its people.
Well then, perhaps I can persuade you to give it up.
Do you think this is ridiculous? Hard to believe? Well, think again. A very similar thing is happening right now in China. Since 1999, the Chinese Communist regime has brutally persecuted practitioners of Falun Gong, also known as Falun Dafa, a spiritual practice with exercises similar to yoga. The Chinese regime blanketed all TV channels with propaganda branding Falun Gong an evil cult. Falun Gong practitioners have been arrested, beaten, electrocuted, killed, and even had their organs harvested to be sold for profit in Chinese hospitals. What is their crime? Taking part in a self-improvement practice based on the principles of truthfulness, compassion, and tolerance. The persecution is now in its 20th year and still continues.
各位观众朋友们，大家好，我希望大家觉得我们拍的这部微电影有意义。这部电影原来是我们想要拍给西方人看的，可是拍完了之后，我们决定加中文字幕放在这个频道上给我们华人的观众看。其实如果你看我们的YouTube频道，我们的Facebook，你可能知道我们以前拍过很多纪录片，可是这是我第一次当一个微电影的导演。过程中我学到很多东西，想要拍这部电影的原因就是因为我太太的爸妈，大家可能知道他们是练法轮功的。 他们在中国大陆被警察抓了很多次，甚至以前被关在劳教所。所以我是为了这个日期拍这部微电影。这个故事是在西方瑜伽被禁止，我们采取这个方式是因为我们想要让西方人了解中共迫害法轮功是多荒谬、多可笑。因为瑜伽在西方虽然那是一个印度的东西，可是在西方已经变得非常普遍、很主流的，就像做体操一样，很多人在练瑜伽。所以你真的可以拿这个瑜伽来做一个比喻，就很像法轮功90年代的时候，99年以前在中国很多人在练。 所以西方人看到这个瑜伽被禁止，被甚至有人被抓了、被迫害，因为练瑜伽被迫害，真的是他们真的可以同情法轮功学员，是一个很像的事情。当然，在西方这一定不会发生，所以是真的是不可思议的。 我们的观众现在可能不知道，我现在有我自己的影片制作公司。我知道有的人已经发现我的一些其他的 YouTube 频道，其实这些 YouTube 频道是英文的，这些 YouTube 频道是一部分，另外一部分就是拍这种微电影。我希望我们接下来可以用我们的制作公司多拍一些有意义的独立微电影。
No morals.
Good cop, by the way. Good cop.
Yeah, he's saying that, but he's also plenty of drugs.